as they go from my job, they're all that way. When I celebrate the best moment, the kids, their course of realization, that I would not be a friend of TV tonight with such a story. Clara, I feel the concept to kill. It is something that is very important to me, and it may not be something that will collect and leave me what they believe to be out. Something that I do believe genuinely will let you really hear what you want to talk about in your career. A silver lining cannot exist without a cloud before me. So to explain my silver lining, I must first focus on the cloud. We are all aware that the world has been through many tragedies. In the recent past, we have been part of the past. But this was an event that shocked and saddened many people across the world. It was a time of devastation. But through the devastation, the world community managed to form and come together in solidarity. Despite such a tragic effect, it was at the same time uplifting to see the love and care that people have for one another. Showing the people that were affected with such a terrible, terrible circumstance that they were there for them to support. The world is also affected in many areas by war. One of the most prominent examples would be the ongoing crisis in Syria. Now, the people in Syria are going through unimaginable experiences of sadness and horror. However, there is still good that is able to come from such a horrific circumstance. Is that people are taking to the streets, welcoming refugees of war into their countries, offering them shelter, support, clothing, food, being there for them, participating in selfless acts who do not have recognition or self reward. They are simply doing it to benefit those who are less fortunate. It reflects that it isn't human nature to do so. That is why we speak. There is a well to help those who are going through struggles. My next concept has been something that has been paramount in my own life, and it is why I'm here today. When I was 17, I completed my A-level exam. My elder brother, Virgil, very sadly passed away. Virgil was 18. He had just completed his first week of university. Not only did I lose my own brother, but I lost my best friend, the first friend I ever had. Virgil and I grew up together. We played in the same teams, joined the same teams, shared the same friendship groups. We really were inseparable, being only a year apart from each. So often the two of us were mistaken for twins, and we could see why. I always loved this. Imagine, when we meet in fact, to be compared to the one person that I lived up to once, the one person that I respected more than anyone else. Virgil was such a good natured person. He always lived out for me. The care and love he showed for me as a younger brother was always there, and it put my needs first. If ever I had a problem, it was Virgil who spoke about it. I was so blessed to have him. Someone who I thought would be there for me and take me through this, and he still not to be so. But I can tell you, God, that I could not be so. I could not be hopeful of things getting better. I could not be great. All I felt was overwhelmed and satisfied. But I did to be so. I did not need to pick myself up. During the time that followed, and ever since. My friends became much more important to me than they ever had before. I realized the dependent and tight friendship that I now know. I relied on the company of genuine and good people. It became evident during the time that followed how much I needed these people in my life. They were there for me. Probably, but I have no doubt that I ever still went through appreciation. But they were not doing it for appreciation. They were doing it simply because they can. But the reason that I have shared this with you, I see you all to understand that despite going through the most tragic experience of my life, there are still people to be. Something that was not possible to hurt as much as I was hurt. I have my family and my friends by my side. So I knew I was important. They wanted to care for me. They wanted to let me know that they were there. And they wanted to show me that I could be happy too. It was never going to be me. But they wanted to show me that sometimes I could feel happiness again. And I needed them. I needed them. Helping us through the most difficult times. Life is filled with turns. Sometimes thunderstorms. Everyone learns as they go through life's journey, because you will be faced with hardships. It can seem like a sad, but I urge you to remember that there is always will always be there to support you and care for you. When I was going through such a tough time, it became surrender for me. But as it is seen globally, it is experienced every day. In the lights of the park, the camps, and in Saturday, you can see the good nature of people. Now, there is a reason when we have to endure and experience sadness. It is one of the most powerful emotions. But just as we cannot appreciate eating a meal of no more than 2 cents to be hungry, nor can we appreciate drinking until you know what it tastes like to be thirsty, I truly believe that you can never enjoy true happiness until you know what it tastes like to be sad. Making you realize the important things you have in life and find meaningful it is to be surrounded by family and friends who will always show you the help and support. I want you to take something with you this evening from what I have said. It may not be a story or a silver lining of incredible success, but it is something that I see as being more important. It is the key message that no matter what challenges you fear in life, no matter how sad you